Next, let's talk about creating document definitions in ABBYY FlexiCapture. So we'll go over what a document definition is, what document definition structure looks like. We'll talk about templates for semi-structured, unstructured, as well as structured documents. And we'll talk about the document definition editor interface. So every document definition in FlexiCapture has the ability to identify documents. So if it's a fixed form or a document definition based on a layout, there's different ways to go about identifying documents. One thing that a document definition accomplishes is it focuses on certain areas of documents to grab data from. So the process of specifying those spaces to capture data from is called marking data fields. And the process is different between fixed forms and semi-structured and unstructured forms. Something that's the same, whether it's a fixed form or an unstructured form or semi-structured, is setting up things like validation rules, verification options, and format checks. So there's a lot that we can do in a document definition editor to make sure that if we have garbage data coming in, we capture that the problems, we fix the problems before the data is exported. So it's very important that we have validation rules and verification options. We can also set up different document assembly rules. So we may have a main document and then supporting pages. We certainly can handle that. And a very important thing that we need to do at the document definition level is set up exports. And that's plural. We can set up more than one export. If we are dealing with structured documents and we wish to mark up documents, it's really a rubber banding task and pretty straightforward. We can simply indicate the area on a fixed form that we want to grab data from. But when we're dealing with semi-structured or unstructured documents, it's a little trickier, and we use Flexi Layout Studio oftentimes to find data that's proximate to keywords. That's one approach that we take. Or we find data that comports with regular expressions. That's another way to find data on a semi-structured or unstructured documents. There's quite a few techniques. So FlexiCapture has the ability to, this is a pretty common use case, find the first and most important data, say like a passport, as the first document in a set of documents. But then we can set up a document definition to have other sections for other pages, maybe supporting documentation that's needed along with a passport. And when you set up these different document definition structures, different document sections, you can say, oh, well, a passport's always a one-page image. That's it. But I could have multiple supporting documents. So we can allow a range of images to come in, and they get electronically stapled to the preceding document, the passport. And we'll talk more about document sections. It's a pretty simple concept, very important, very powerful. Document definitions have items to identify the document. So we can identify the document based on finding some keyword here, or even finding, a cornerstone. That can help us find the actual data. And then we've got fields that actually collect the data. There is a difference between fixed form document identification and semi-structured and unstructured. So for fixed forms, very typically we will rubber band a specific string in a specific area. And when we do that, we'll say, well, we can not read a few of the characters because of low quality, and that's okay. With semi-structured forms, it's a bit of a different approach. We still look for certain text strings, but in this case, the text strings can actually occur anywhere. We're not, unlike fixed forms, We're positionally agnostic, I like to say. We have the ability in FlexiCapture to read things like check marks, barcodes, and text fields. And each one of these fields have a number of processing settings to make sure we're getting the best results possible. So the main steps of setting up a document definition, when you create a brand new doc def, a wizard is launched and it asks you to bring in a sample image for that doc def. And then technology for recognition. Is this going to be a handprint form or machine print? So you specify that. And then for a fixed form, you're given tools to indicate the areas that you want to capture. So for semi-structured and unstructured forms, you use Flexi Layout Studio to find that data. So you go about creating fields, then you set up recognition settings. Is this a handprint or machine print? There's a lot of different settings that you can use to make sure you're getting good results. Then you set up validation rules, data verification settings, maybe database lookups, format checks, a lot of different work that we can do there. Then you set up document assembly. So do we have, like in our example earlier, a passport always is the first page, and then we've got supporting documents after that. You can set up rules to accommodate that kind of data collection, and we have a GUI interface that allows you to do that. We'll be looking at that later. Finally, you want to test your document definition, and you can actually test your document definition right in the document definition editor, which is a real time saver. So we talked briefly about what a document definition consists of. It has the ability to identify a document. It specifies specific fields to for recognition, and those fields have certain settings. If you have a fixed form, you can just go to the document definition editor and rubber band the data, the areas that you want to collect data from. If it's a semi-structured or unstructured form, you bring up Flexi Layout Studio and create the algorithms to identify the form and to collect data, and then you import that logic into the document definition editor, where you can set up exports and data validation checks and whatnot.